Hello everyone, my name is Mythrell and welcome back to this Operation Nighthawk, the Advent Retaliation, the first one, and its difficulty is rated easy. So I spent quite a long time to equipping my squad and I decided to not put this that there because, or here because that took me something like 15 minutes. Anyway, as you can see, Spendra has the boltcaster. I wanted to put the SMG on the, or keep the SMG on shock trooper, so I gave her the flashbang. And usually I use the shock troopers with the boltcaster, but I kind of want to see how the submachine gun works out. And yeah, everyone has their shirt on, XCOM shirt. The axes are on Bruce Lee, I suppose. And what else? The pistol is actually on Mayo, the Alien Hunter's pistol. Because I feel like the concealment from the Shadowfall makes a lot more sense on somebody else than the sniper. And then we have the sniper, or sharpshooter, I suppose. The flashbang is here. And yeah, the frost grenade is with us, with Spendra, so yeah, let's do it.
Sky Ranger deployed.
I need to actually
in position for deployment.
Check what type of mission this is.
Now that we've got the aliens' attention, they're taking it out on one of the resistance outposts in the area. We're heading in to secure the camp and protect as many civilians as we can. Eliminate all hostile forces attacking the site. Make them regret coming after the resistance.
Okay, so this seems to be a normal retaliation. I don't know if the additional mission types is actually activated, because usually for some weird reason, get a lot of those missions in the beginning, but I'm happy if they are finally somehow come only in the later game, because none of those are easy. But it just begs the question that do I have the mod activated? I mean, I will double check that after this mission. I'm fairly certain that I do, but I'm just so used to see the second, third, and even the fourth mission to be from the additional mission types. That's why we have this six-member squad. Because those missions are just damn difficult. Or insane, if you ask me, sometimes. Oh! Well, that's a welcome party.
Hostile forces are attacking the outpost. Eliminate all enemy units and protect those civilians. Advent came in hot and so did we. You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
So we're kind of in the middle of the map, but on this edge, so there is that, but we got the sectoid and a bushwhacker right away. Try to save these civilians. I think I will. Alright, here's the area suppression. Okay, let's check this.
Sure thing.
If these are faceless, it's gonna be a problem anyway.
You're clear. Go.
Oh, we have a lot of civilians here. Some of them are bound to be faceless, I suppose. Or this guy even. I should probably check that first. We do have one guy, the professor, who is shinobi in concealment, but that's about it. Nobody actually has movement except for the shinobi. Huh. Well. I don't think this voice pack, the showdown voice pack, is really working. I mean, it's just too damn quiet. Revenge actually has that Okay, I could save this civilian, but I don't know if it's worth this kind of risky move. Then again, she does have that flame burst, which might actually kill somebody. No, we're not gonna do that, I don't think. Can the gunner actually throw a grenade? He can. These trees are sometimes quite tough, so... they might not go down with one grenade. I think I will go for the... primarily for the... sector action. Well, he might actually run, so let's try to kill this guy. Come on.
Frag out!
Okay, I think I got the tree there. That guy actually has 6 health already. Siphon is not able to get to that guy even with the run and gun. But actually I could use the Shinobi's flesh air, I suppose. If I wanna get rid of the concealment, we'll see. That guy is weak, so I think I will use the submachine gun to try to kill that guy. But yeah, that cover did not break up, so... I could actually frame burst. Damage 3 to 4. If I can get it from here. I'm gonna check it.
Whatever you say.
And if this is a faceless, this is actually pretty stupid.
Go on, get out of
okay,
here!
Okay, good. Yeah, I could definitely kill that guy, okay? So can we kill the other guy is the question. Try with the boltcaster, I suppose. Yeah, let's see if we're gonna get the conflict. Nice! Spender is definitely here to play. Okay, I'm gonna actually see if this is a guaranteed kill or not. I think it just does the damage, no matter what.
Toasty.
I really like that effect. Yeah, we actually did not use that skill for once on the previous run. So I'm happy that we finally got a use out of it. Siphon is really, really slow. I suppose I could grenade that guy as a backup if I miss the sword swing from here. Yeah.
Let's move already.
Okay. I suppose I should actually give the axe to the Shinobi. We're gonna lose the concealment right away. Well, there is the sniper shot. Both of these are just terrible. But I suppose there's no actually. There's no penalty. Why? I don't know why he gets likes men. Well, I suppose it is most of the squad, right? Only plus 5 aim. That's something, I suppose. Yeah, let's see if he can get this lucky hit. Oh yeah, I just realized that we might actually uncover new enemies with this flash. Oh, but we can do it from behind the fence, that is actually perfect. Cool. Oh, wrong button.
Sugar, yes.
That actually does a lot of damage. I didn't even consider the added damage for the flasher. How much is it? I don't even know how to pronounce that, by the way. But I'm gonna assume it is flasher after the flasher round or something. No, Attack any enemy within movement range with your sword. Deals plus one damage for every three tiles. So that will add up. We did 8 damage there, so it wasn't actually that much. I think we will go for these civilians next.
Absolutely.
Spender on is a reload. I think I will get the sniper on this. Height advantage. Yeah.
I understand. Moving.
That is pretty good. Somehow I feel like Bruce Lee is the slowest guy. Well, he only has movement of 11 and he has to be the close range guy, so this is gonna be, well, he's gonna dash a lot.
Running.
Let me just say that. Or luckily most of the other guys are quite mobile, so
seems doable.
Got it covered.
Moi, c'est faisable.
Professor is now revealed, so.
Affirmative. Je couvre la zone.
Thank you, spot. Okay, no faceless so far. Mustafa Rahman, I'm sorry you have to die. There's actually no cover to move into. That's kind of weird. Ah, let's go our way.
You're good to go.
Okay. And Bruce Lee can then grab this guy.
Finally. Go on. Head to the ship.
So far, so good, I suppose. Do I dare to go for this one? No, no, no. It's much better if we don't get spotted right now.
I'm going.
We only need to get two more civilians anyway. Yeah, you just steady the weapon. I suppose the steady weapon kind of removes the Overwatch, so.
Moving to Overwatch. Overwatch.
You either Overwatch or you steady the weapon.
On Overwatch.
Okay, we got a fist. Oh, I can see many civilians behind the faceless.
We've heard rumors about some kind of shapeshifters. I'm guessing this is it.
It is a remarkable species. If only we had some means of containment.
Don't even think about it.
Nice. I saw that. Pretty cool, man. Pretty cool. God, Bruce Lee, so slow. I think I will grab this guy and
whatever you say.
See if we get enemies.
You're clear. Go.
I mean, maybe with the submachine gun, revenge is very, very fast. 18 movement. That's actually a lot. I think the submachine gun gives him her 3 movement. So. She's pretty fast even without it. I think we are gonna head towards these three guys next.
Tired of waiting around.
Hopefully not find
not a problem.
More enemies just yet. Oh, this is actually not cover. I don't actually know if keeping the sniper up here is that good yet, because... Well, I'm gonna keep him here with the steady weapon one more turn. I can actually reload and then steady.
Let me reload.
And then move him behind the squad.
Affirmative, covering now. Scanning.
Humanity is on the
edge of a
new era.
Scanning.
Oh. Never mind. Oh, there's civilians on top of the building as well. For a moment there, I thought we had second phases. Maybe I will attack those guys this turn. He was very, very close here, so... Let's see if we can get them.
Seems doable. Advent troop spotted!
Is this the same squad, even? I don't think it is. Well, it very well could be also. Where is this explosive? Right next to that guy, okay. We do have 100% flank shot on him, so I think that's pretty much a no-brainer here. And straight to the head. No-brainer indeed.
Join in.
Okay then. I'd like to take care of that surveillance drone as well, but our cover options are kind of limited. Maybe what we need to do is actually get some holes in this wall. I could just go flash air in. If that damage reading is right. Oh. Right here. I could just outright kill it. Or I would get a shotgun shot from there. Actually, where is Bender? Just can't quite get there. Shame. I mean, how much do I wanna put faith on that flesh air? I suppose I can always blow the wall up if it fails. And then there's the question, was this the same spawn which shot that guy from behind there? Actually, there's no window on this, so maybe it should be safe. Let's check. I believe in you, Bruce Lee. Do it. Oh my god.
You can't handle me!
Finally, the melee weapons are just crazy good.
Oh,
and we rolled high damage on that as well.
Burning
nice.
Through ammo fast!
I don't think anybody else can get a shot on the drone, unfortunately. But we can set up some overwatches, maybe he will.
Je dois pouvoir faire ça.
Or it will fly into one of those.
Come get some!
Viens par là!
Oh, he ran away. Okay. Well. I mean, I could grab this civilian and yeah, let's do it.
I can handle that.
If that is a faceless, this is gonna be kinda interesting, but...
Why are you just standing around? Go!
Status confirmed.
Okay.
We've secured a civilian contact.
On my way.
I think that's international signal to just regroup or what. And can I move outside here? Apparently this square is taken. Huh.
Here I come.
But yeah, I'm gonna regroup, reload, do all that. And there's no window on that wall, which is kinda weird as well.
Back in. Let's rock.
This steady weapon actually works pretty well with the reloading.
Touch it.
She needs a reload.
Rock and roll.
Nobody died either. Okay. Wow, look at this movement. I mean, she's just insane. She's out of control. Hopefully I don't move her right into her death.
Whatever you say. You're safe, now get out of here!
I mean, I just love that.
Finally!
Okay, nothing here.
Bad sushi, chef.
With these skills, I'm actually starting
sure to
really feel that we're actually gonna be fine.
I am in control.
Or as she would say, we are in control.
I'm on it. Got it covered. Visionos.
I'm on it.
Oh. Hello, faceless. Taking our planet back. That's a nice poster. Oh, here is the squad.
Let the aliens attack! They're shifting their attack!
Gonna get a swipe. Oh no, don't kill the tree health guy. Okay. May you're somehow saved. How do you do not see the faceless? I suppose this tree. Okay. I think Spender can deal with the faceless. And yeah, sure, Mayo. Bring it down.
By the numbers. Toss me some ammo.
I can get a good flank here. Where is that? Did that Psy Soldier die already? I don't even remember. There's a corpse here, so maybe it did. No. Whatever the case. Bruce Lee, take that
Let's
shotgun shot
this.
Here. Nice.
How many is that now?
That's not a brilliant shot. My professor can have a better one. Oh. Just one short of flanking. I mean, he could do the flash air. One thing. Oh yeah, you cannot waypoint here. I was thinking maybe that's a way to cheat the system. Not that I was gonna do it, but I was just interested if that is possible. So you could kind of run around a guy and then hit it, which would be extremely stupid.
Seems doable.
But apparently no, you cannot do that. There you go, revenge.
Running dry on ammo.
One hit point. Oh, that's really bad. Okay. Sniper, try to take him down. Nice. And loot!
The mark is down.
Hair trigger, finally a weapon upgrade.
What am I doing with this?
Now the question is, did the Advent Psy operative die? And I think that looks like it. I just wasn't paying attention. I was so excited about my guys. I mean, it's going to be very, very stupid if he didn't die and he's going to kill one of our guys. Yep. Oh, the surveillance drone didn't die. Okay. Oh no.
Jardez la cible.
Okay, stunner I'm fine with. I don't think that does damage. Yeah. So that's actually not that bad.
Let's move already.
Okay, and the shotgun will do. That's fine, yeah.
Who's keeping score?
Menace 1-5,
nice.
Status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
I mean, it's an easy mission with 10 enemies. And I have not seen that many stun lancers, because in all my test games, all I got was stun lancers. Different variations of stun lancers. And I mean, maybe the Lady Luck is just smiling on this campaign. I mean, I'm sure it will get more tough before it gets easier. But yeah, now I kind of feel bad for having that sixth guy. But maybe the difference is that I have that sixth guy and it just... everything just goes smooth. Because seriously, all my test games, on the second or third mission, I had lost something like 10 guys already.
Good work out there, Commander. The aliens must be getting nervous by now.
Penetrating burst. Preparedness. There's actually no third skill tree, which I didn't realize. There's only one for the last skill, so it's not as compatible with the perks as I thought. Preparedness, one health, one armor, and resistance to stunning attacks. I mean, the penetrating burst is kind of funny. That have retreated from line of sight. I mean, I think this will suit at everyone. Furnished straight line, 2 ammo cost, 3 turn cooldown. You know what? I'm gonna take the preparedness. Yeah. I mean, she has kinda low health anyway. I do hope that she actually gets a benefit from that skill. I'm gonna recheck that. Okay, so here's the first skill. Skill choice for the assault. I mean, the close combat specialist from what I've seen is absolutely ridiculously good. You may shoot at each enemy with this ability once per turn. Okay, it doesn't actually explain the skill there. During enemy turns, fire free a reaction shot with your primary weapon at any visible enemy within 4 tiles who moves or fires. Say hello to all the chrysalids. Close and personal, confers plus 30 critical chance against adjacent targets. The bonus declines with distance from the target. I mean, that's not bad either, but it's not even close to being as good. Formidable. Your gear includes an extra layer of protection, granting a bonus point of armor and 66 less percent less damage from explosive attacks. Why it's not just the padding thing? Is there a difference? I mean, I suppose this doesn't give you the hit point. But still, don't really know why I would ever pick this. Okay. We're obviously gonna go with close combat specialist for the first guy. Professor. Covered. Enemies have 20% smaller detection range against you. Huh. Low profile makes partial cover count as full. That's the old sniper skill actually. Blademaster Oswald attacks deal plus 2 extra damage and have plus 10 aim. With flechette that would be actually pretty insane. Enemies have 20% smaller detection range against you. I mean, I suppose I could double that with this submachine gun actually. Ah, that feels kinda lackluster actually. I do wanna kinda have the scouting or the phantom build. But I feel like this is kinda lackluster skill. Do I go for the full flesh air build? I mean plus 2 damage and extra 10 aim. I do hope that it actually affects flesh air. Ah, this low profile is actually very good as well. I'm gonna take the Blademaster. Hard choices, hard choices. Cool. And we finally got the hair trigger. This is not the most exciting first weapon item.
Another impressive effort, Commander. My expectations were high, and yet you have exceeded them.
Good stuff. Okay, I'm just double checking the fatigue thing. So right now we have a Monkey Mac and who else? I don't even remember on the living quarters. Monkey Mac and our land. Yeah, this really should show the fatigue timers right here. That would make life so much easier. Yeah, it was Lance, so Henry will be out of fatigue very quickly, so I'm gonna switch him. How about Monkey Mac? Monkey Mac still has some work to do, so I'm gonna switch Henry. Look at those notorieties. They're already getting very, very high. And the notoriety mod actually adds all kind of weird stuff. I believe it launches every 10 days. Or is the limit 10 days? So after 10 days, enemies will get one backup spawn and more enemies and stuff like that. So the last ones are very, very nasty. So you definitely do not wanna get guy out back or when the situation is bad like that. I suppose I will just put the Bruce Lee actually, since he has the longest. Well, actually, yeah, Spendera. Spender a grenadier or only grenadier. Yeah, let's do that. Jana, you're up. Do they actually go to the living quarters? We have central chilling out here. Henry was here. Oh yeah, there. That's Spender probably from the hair. Revenge, others are chilling here. The bulge was back there. I saw. Okay, enough of that. Let's continue scanning. Ooh, rookies. Excellent.
Avenger plotting new course.
So first, we finish this supply cache. Okay. Then the burning
Avenger
convoy.
Avenger plotting new course.
I should really start scanning at this before the supply drop, but that's quite a long.
I think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing.
Quite a long away from now. Magnetic weapons, great. Another thing we won't be doing. I mean, the faces autopsy is pretty hope, but we don't actually have faceless bodies enough to build the mimic beacon anyway, so it's kind of pointless, yeah. So maybe we don't have the proving ground, so this is pointless as well. Resistance radio? I mean, these are just so long. But I suppose at some point you just have to do them. There's just no other way around. So, should I just go for the magnetic weapons right now? I think I can switch the research anyway without it cancelling, so yeah, let's do that for now.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Okay. That's 25, that's really not...
Avenger plotting new course.
Not even worth scanning, to be honest. And yeah, I can finish this without, before supply drop and make contact. Well then, a new mission. Oh, Hunt XCOM, excellent. I don't like the early Hunt XCOM. We've had that in two previous seasons, and it's just nasty. Yeah,
setting course
we're gonna go there, definitely. And this probably will not be the squad, I can say that much. But I actually wanted to do something before, because we have the new guy before I end this episode. We have the new guy, so American. What was your bio? Did I even check it? Oh, it was the hell yeah. Okay, that's made by me. Yep. Cool. And soon we will have more recruits. This is almost all the soldiers sent to me. There are still a couple missing, like Elizabeth and some other guys, but. But we will probably see them after the scanning that rookies thing. I will end the episode here a little bit short. Or maybe I will equip the squad. Yeah, that makes sense. That way we won't be actually short. And I can just start it in the next episode. Clear the whole squad. We're gonna try to avoid using fatigued guys. Specialist, huh? Oh, it's going to be one of these. So this is from the additional mission type, so... Neutralize Advent VIP on Pierto. This is gonna be insane. So, yeah. Suppose, Lance, you're in. I've had it 18 hours. Darkson may be the sniper for this mission. I should really pick the 8 team, shouldn't I? Besides, I have to pick some fatigue guys, just no other way. Suspender will be in. I do have two non-fatigue guys here, but... Maybe I will go with the professor. And Milena revenge, because she's just so good. And grenade, t-shirt, make items available, make weapons available, prefer the boltcaster to go someone else. Get the cool sniper rifle. It is kind of short though. And I think we can now build something, yeah. So I think it's definitely worth going for the 6 high quality rounds. They're just pretty good. Actually get everyone tile quality runs. Let's use the new weapons because we have them. Actually, Bulge, you take the boltcaster, spender up, you take the rifle. Boltcaster here. We have the freeze grenade, sure. I think I will give the hunter's axe to Flesher, or the not the Flesher, but the Francis Professor, because he's kind of the squad in it. Everyone should have ammo. New shotgun. So yeah, I tried to fix my mod to actually work with this and solve all the slots here, but I ended up wasting 2 days on it and not getting it to work, so scratch that idea, I suppose. Yeah, I don't know why it's so hard, but apparently it is. Just if you are wondering about that. And when I talk about my mod, I talk about the ammo and vest slot mods, which are these two. Do I wanna have the hair trigger on somebody? I suppose which weapon would actually benefit from that the most? I mean, the sniper is pretty good. Yeah, I have to think about that. Maybe I won't put it on yet, because I feel like the hair trigger is not the best mod for anyone. Okay, yeah. Revenge will still have the flashbang. And this will be the squad for the next mission. So, see you guys there. Bye.